In this video, we're going to fill in the missing coordinates for three different rectangles. We're going to start with rectangle EPHS, and we're going to use the fact that we're given this point is MN. And so with that, we know that the distance from here to here has to be M units, and the distance from here to here has to be N units. Because it's a rectangle, we know that this side is congruent to that side, so that's also M. And we know that these two sides have to be congruent. So obviously E is at the point 0, 0. If we move over here to S, because we're moving out M units, but we're staying on the x-axis, that's the point M0. And for point P, because we are going straight up on the y-axis, that's going to be the point 0, N. For rectangle twin, we're given this point EG. So we now know that the distance from here out to here is E, and the distance from here up to here has to be G. So we know that from these congruency marks, we know that from here to here has to be congruent, so this is also E. And so we can figure out the first ordered pair over here for I. Or we could do W, it doesn't matter where you start. Let's just start with W. So this is the point E0, and because we're going to the left to get to I, that's going to be the point negative E0. Last point we need to get is N, and we know that we're moving out to the left E units, so that's going to be negative E, and then we are going to go up the same distance as this leg over here, so that has to be G units. In rectangle sing, they don't give us any points to work from, so that means we're just going to make some up. So we'll just start over here with G, and I'm going to say that the distance from here out to here is A, which makes this ordered pair A0. For point N, again, we're just going to make up a distance. So I'm going to say that the distance from here to here is G. Therefore, point N, we're going to the right A units, and we're going up G units. Moving over here to S, what you have to notice is that there's no congruency markings here or here, so we have to assume that this distance is different than this one. So we're going to go ahead and say that this is, you can use whatever you want, but because you're going to the left to get to here, let's just say that that is negative C0. And then finally for point I, you're going to the left C, so the x value is negative C. And then you're going up the same distance as you did here. So this would be G.